On behalf of everyone at Girls Inc. of Orange County, I'd like to welcome you to our first ever live stream event. My name is Bea, and I will be your host for today. I think it's absolutely awesome that anyone can join us for the first time. So whether you live here in Orange County or somewhere else, welcome. I want to take you on a journey with me, a journey of what it's like to be 16, attend classes virtually, and even socialize online with my friends. But most importantly, I'm here to tell you what Girls Inc. has done for me. This is why we themed our event, My Virtual Reality, because really, it's been the reality for all of us right now. Oh, and since you're joining us at lunchtime, please enjoy your lunch. And for those who participated in our guest experience with a beautiful meal, our co-host, Chef Jamie Gwen, is going to give you a fun tip to make this shared virtual lunch experience even more special. So stay tuned. I'd also like to thank our generous sponsors. Without them, today wouldn't have been possible. You will see on the screen the names of the companies and individuals who believe in our mission, which is to inspire all girls to be strong, smart, and bold. Thank you so much for supporting Girls Inc. of Orange County. We're so grateful. Now, I want to let you know that there are Girls Inc. girls online with us right now and ready to share their experiences with you in the chat box. So this is your opportunity to ask them any questions that you'd like as we take you through the next 40 minutes. So go for it. Let me tell you how I got involved at Girls Inc. of Orange County. Last year, I'd say around September or so, I attended a local youth government summit for my city, and Girls Inc. happened to be there advertising their new advocacy program. At the time, I knew I had growing interest in politics and social justice, so I thought, you know what? Let's try this out. I attended the first meeting, and right away, it felt like home. There were so many girls from all around the county who shared the same interest as me, which was resolving human rights issues. At the beginning of every Girls Inc. program, the educator always tells us, remember that this is a safe space. This allowed me to feel like I could share my thoughts and opinions without being fearful of critical judgment. This inspired me to actively participate in each class, and I even took initiative in all of our projects. After this program ended, I was hooked and ready for some more Girls Inc. programming, so I joined this year's virtual Eureka. In Eureka, I was able to socialize with other girls, participate in accessible STEM projects, learn more about social justice, all while engaging in exciting competitions. This was the first summer of my life where I couldn't hang out with any of my friends. But luckily, with Girls Inc., I was able to create even more friendships. By far, however, the most memorable experience I've had here at Girls Inc. of Orange County is being able to speak at the United States of Young Women Conference. At first, the idea of speaking at a national conference made me a little bit nervous, but I knew with Girls Inc.'s guidance and my passion, I'd be able to speak with confidence as I inspired many young girls in our nation. Girls Inc. also motivates me to excel in school, and I'm so excited to be a senior next year and join College Bound. So yes, I may have been here for only a year, but already, Girls Inc. has exposed me to so many new opportunities. Girls Inc. has helped me make new friends. Girls Inc. has connected me to so many strong female role models. Girls Inc. has helped me find my passion. But most importantly, Girls Inc. has helped me discover the power I hold within myself. So this is why I love Girls Inc. and I'm so excited to be here with you today. And now I'd like to introduce our event co-chairs, Chef Jamie Gwen and Janet Michaels.
Hi all, I'm Janet Michaels and I've been a passionate advocate for Girls Inc. for over 10 years and a member of the board of directors since 2013. I'm standing outside the new headquarters for Girls Inc. in Santa Ana, where we have this beautiful courtyard space and enjoying a beautiful day. Thanks for joining us today. My husband Mike and I, along with Chef Jamie Gwen, are co-chairing the event today, and we wish we could greet you in a big, beautiful ballroom, but that's just not gonna happen this year. So rather than being bummed out, I created a short list of why attending a virtual event is even better. Number one, getting here is a breeze. You don't even have to get in your car. Number two, you can wear anything you want, shorts, flip-flops, bare feet, doesn't matter. We aren't gonna see you. Number three, you can eat dessert first and nobody is going to judge you. Number four, the event is only 45 minutes long. You can spend that much time here today. And number five, the best benefit of being in a virtual event is you don't have to wait in line for the valet with 300 other guests. We are so glad you decided to make the decision to join us today. Girls Inc. of Orange County has made our community stronger for over 65 years. And we hope during the next 45 minutes, you're gonna be inspired to contribute to our future. So now let me turn it over to my, seemed to have lost my co-chair. With social distancing and all that, she's somewhere else. Jamie, where'd you go?
Okay, I'm on my way. Ah. Okay, Janet, I made it.
Phew.
Whew. I'm glad to see you.
You too.
Thank you. You can go change now.
I am changed. I just told everybody they could wear what they want. What's wrong with this?
Yes, and you look gorgeous.
Thank you, as do you.
Thank you kindly. This is my casual. And I'm delighted to be here with all of you. Right here at the new Girls Inc. offices, as Janet mentioned, centrally located so that we can serve more strong, smart, bold girls. I'm Chef Jamie Gwen, your co-chair for this virtual event. And along with Lana Sills, who is my mom and a previous board member of Girls Inc., we have been advocates of Girls Inc. for almost 18 years now. We hope that you're enjoying this beautiful lunch. Impressive, right? And we want to give a big shout out and a thank you to our dear friends, Chef Amar Santana and his business partner, Ahmed Labat of the Hall Global Eatery at South Coast Plaza. This is truly a delectable way to gather together and enjoy a meal virtually. We want you to know that this meal was locally inspired and locally sourced. And I thought I would share a tip for a beautiful place setting, seeing that we are sharing this guest experience virtually. We hope that you found in your bag my new favorite find. It is a totally disposable linen napkin, and we hope that it's nestled underneath your bubbly glass so that you'll join us in a toast. We'd like to thank Northern Trust for underwriting our champagne toast today. Janet, are you ready to cheers?
Well, wait a minute.
Sure.
I brought my own glass.
Of course you did.
Is that okay? Now I'm ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, cheers, Janet, to you and to the resiliency of girls strong, smart, and bold. We thank you for continuing to support Girls Inc. and for celebrating with us today. Now, are you ready to see what it's like to engage virtually with Girls Inc.? Let's watch how it all comes together for our staff and our girls.
When our in-person and in-school programming was halted in March of 2020, Girls Inc. of Orange County did what we always do best, connect with our girls. Within a week of school closures, we began creating content for our YouTube channel. To date, we have uploaded 87 videos, gained 300 subscribers, and amassed over 8,600 views. This summer, we made our holistic comprehensive programming a virtual reality by launching them on the online learning platform Canvas. With COVID-19 impacting our girls' realities, Girls Inc. of Orange County has strengthened five areas of our programming to equip girls with the skills they need in this new world. Emerging research is showing the mental health implications our girls are facing because of the COVID-19 pandemic. We have seen the negative impact firsthand. This is a post from one of our girls who attended our virtual Eureka summer camp. Because of the virtual setting, we were able to quickly communicate within the Girls Inc. of Orange County team and take action to immediately check in with the original poster and connect her with specialized resources, all done within seconds. Girls Inc. of Orange County has been a leader in advocating for racial and gender equity for over 65 years, and our efforts have continued in the virtual setting. This summer, Generation Giga Girls virtual program gave girls powerful tools to become advocates in their communities. Members of our teen advocacy group, Informed, In Charge, and In Action, led a breakout session at the United States of Young Women virtual conference. 185 people registered to hear our girls speak about how to end toxic masculinity in schools. This fall, our advocacy program will lead a new project in the area of gender and race equity. Academic intervention is crucial as students adapt to distance learning. To prevent summer learning loss and adapt to virtual programming, we created a new camp, STEM in a Bag. This camp provided second to fifth grade girls with a bag of materials to use throughout the program. Girls spent synchronous time with a Girls Inc. of Orange County educator to learn the STEM activity for the day with step-by-step instructions and a model example. Outside of synchronous time, girls conducted the activity or experiment with their family. This fall, we are launching a new program, Logic Lab, to assist girls in reaching math proficiencies. With Girls Inc. of Orange County STEM programs, girls will have a virtual space to continue exploring and sparking their interests in science, technology, engineering, and math. Here is a STEM in a Bag participant, Brielle, showing off her activity.
You're about to see my awesome project, a water filter. You can see how I'm pulling it slowly in the middle.
Is it as dirty as what we started with here?
Nope, so it works.
It works.
Research shows that the greatest indicator that a child would drop out of school is not reaching grade level reading by the end of third grade. For 7 years, our literacy lab program has helped kindergarten through third grade girls successfully reach grade level reading proficiency. This summer, our YouTube literacy lab video lessons assisted girls with identifying their emotions. The read aloud videos feature a book read by a Girls Inc. of Orange County educator. Our literacy team held live sessions and story times on Zoom for girls to interact with each other and our educators. This fall, Literacy Lab will take place on Canvas with more hands-on literacy activities and opportunities for girls to read aloud to a literate adult. COVID-19 has made girls feel their academic futures are uncertain. College Bound breaks down the social and economic barriers our girls face when planning their academic futures. This fall, College Bound is held on Canvas, where we have welcomed our most diverse cohort, serving over 90 girls who represent 30 different schools in Orange County. With the cohort's GPAs ranging from 1.8 to 4.8, College Bound shows participants that higher education is for anyone who has the desire to learn. 100% of the 2019-2020 College Bound cohort was accepted and is attending college this fall, with 50% of the 2020-2021 cohort first-generation students, first in their family to attend college. We are excited to lead these girls to further academic success. Through these areas of focus, Girls Inc. of Orange County lets girls know that their reality, though virtual, is as strong, smart, and bold as ever.
How cool, right? I sure hope everyone is chatting with other Girls Inc. girls about how awesome your virtual experience is with us today. Oh, I see Gina Reed and Kim Shepherd are loving our content. Thank you so much for all of the positive feedback. Speaking of thanking everyone, I'd like to give a special shout out to Disneyland Resorts for their ongoing support of Girls Inc. programs and for girls like me. Many of us girls aspire to be a CEO. So let's hear it from the CEO of Girls Inc. of Orange County, Lucy Santana.
Thank you, Bea. And thank you to all of you for being here today. It is amazing to look and see all of the chat box entertainment that's happening, and we really appreciate your thoughts. Bea, thank you for letting our audience see you in what is your now new reality. So thank you, everybody. At Girls Inc., we believe in the strengths of every girl that walks through our doors, and we know that every girl in Orange County is strong, smart, and bold. In our work, we know that not only do we need to be in their lives for an extended period of time, but we also need to make sure that we're there for them each and every day and that reach them out at any time that we can. We know that girls are willing to work hard and overcome the odds and to be able to navigate through socioeconomic barriers as well as gender stereotypes. We want to make sure that they're feeling that they can do this. So for now, we know that given the right opportunities, the right education, girls will thrive. And they become leaders, not only in their community, but in their schools as well. We see every day girls like Bea and girls such as in our chat box being strong, smart, and bold. And we see them being able to overcome. But here's a fact. 83% of the girls that we serve are living in homes that are earning below the poverty line. And we know that in Orange County, it is expensive to live here. We know that our girls are navigating through very difficult situations right now. They're navigating through a virtual education. They're sometimes having to take care of their siblings. And they're also watching their parents struggle. We've seen some of their families lose their jobs. Then we've seen decrease in wages, as well as they're not able to be there to help their girls navigate through this new normal. And that concerns me, especially because currently of the 90 girls that are in our college-bound program, we have found that we've had to make more calls than in previous years to Child Protective Services. And these are the girls that are highly involved in our program. These are the girls that come to us and are part of our nurturing environment. So our concern is, what happens to all the girls that are out there that we're not currently reaching? And these girls are getting the mentorship and support that they need right now. But with more than 350,000 girls in Orange County, we're only serving 4,000 girls right now. So if these girls are struggling, how can we help and how can we really reach out to more girls? Well, a national study from the American Institute of the Research determined that regardless of demographics, academics, and social characteristics, girls participated in Girls Inc. programs were outpacing their peers in multiple areas of success. Successes such as avoiding early teen pregnancy, substance abuse, attaining higher level of education, and have higher attendance in school as well, and have healthier relationships and have a better self-confidence. We know that girls can, and we know that girls do. But we need you to invest in Girls Inc. Girls Inc. has the opportunity and has the capacity, and we are ready to grow. Your financial investment in Girls Inc. allows us to continue to deepen our work and to not only continue to serve our Girls Inc. girls that we have in our programs today, but to be able to reach new girls throughout Orange County. So we can and we will ensure that girls are graduating from college, that they're pursuing careers in STEM, that they grow to love reading, and a pandemic or no pandemic, we're gonna be there for them and we're gonna support them. So we can't do this without your help. So please join us in helping us to inspire girls to be strong, smart, and bold. With your support, we can do so much more. And now, here's a story about another Girls Inc. girl, Sanaya. Please watch her video and thank you.
Normal, meaning conforming to a standard. Usual, typical, or expected. My life was just that, normal. My name is Sanaya. I'm 16 years old and I'm a senior. Not saying that my life was easy, because it was far from it, but the difficulty and busyness were my normal. I would wake up, go to school, have a million extracurriculars to do. I'm the president of my Black Student Union at school. I'm the vice president of my school show choir and have served for 2 years in my associated student body as student representative and public relations commissioner. I have held 2 pageant titles and the list goes on. But after all of that, I'd come home, do my homework for hours, and then go to sleep. It was my own personal routine. A pretty normal routine for me that had taken up all of my time and energy until one day it didn't anymore. It feels like a tornado. Not the kind that carries you and your dog to this magical world in which your dreams come true, but more like the kind that rips through your town and destroys everything with no fairy tale on the other side. I was sent home from school on an extended spring break that we would never return from. That's when the winds of the tornado started picking up. My teachers and administration were running around like chickens with their heads cut off, trying to figure out how on earth school was even possible. Programs I am a part of were closing their doors left and right. My parents lost their jobs, and loneliness inevitably started to seep its way into my brain. It felt like a nightmare, not the one that you wake up from and ignore, but the kinds that are burned into your brain, making it impossible to forget. Then, on top of all of the chaos, police brutality and racism was sweeping through our country like a wildfire. All that I yearned for was that normal that I used to take for granted. I just wanted something that I could depend on, something that could hold me to the ground tightly and securely as the tornado tried to take me with it. Then came Girls Inc. I had finally reached the eye, the calm in the storm. I was signed up for the Eureka Summer Camp, and it quickly became the one thing in my life that was consistent. Girls Inc. was turning on when everything else turned off. The staff was embracing the reality of the situation and decided to make it as positive as possible. I was able to have real interactions with girls my age. I was learning, growing, transforming, and it honestly felt really good. I was given a space where I didn't have to focus on the destruction and chaos that ensued. I could just log on, be myself, and have fun. I don't even think I knew it at the time, but Girls Inc. was changing my life. I was able to shift my outlook on all that was happening in the world. Things are still crazy and probably always will be, but Girls Inc. reminded me that I was finally in control and I decided how I was going to handle everything that was going on. My journey with Girls Inc. is far from over. I have just started their college bound program because I'm a senior now, and with that comes the race for college, which we all know is getting harder and harder as years pass. But I know that if anyone could prepare me for what this world has to throw at me, it's Girls Inc. I am strong, smart, and bold, and I'm ready to make changes in this world. Tornado winds still blow around me, and uncertainty shows itself around every corner. But I know that I'm not alone. For now, this is my new normal, but it is just the beginning for my virtual reality. And with Girls Inc. in my corner, my reality and my future look brighter than ever.
Thank you for sharing your story, Sanaya. I'm Sherry Delaney Dakey with New Market Wealth Management and a Girls Inc. board member. I'm here today to ask you to join me in supporting more girls like Sanaya and Bea through Girls Inc. of Orange County. Hearing from Sanaya and Bea gives me hope for the future generations of women leaders. Join me today for Sponsor a Girl and give what you can to continue these life-changing opportunities through Girls Inc. Now, I'd like to turn it over to our auctioneer.
Hi, my name is Zan Ofterhide, and I'm your auctioneer, which means this is the fundraising portion of the event. So what I want you to do is grab your phone so that you can play along. I know you've got it nearby, just like me. So grab that phone, because what we're doing right now with Sponsor a Girl is we are trying to raise enough money so that all girls can come to Girls Inc. and enjoy the programs. And the reality is, it can't happen without you. We really need your support. So we're going to give you an opportunity right now to give to your heart's content, anywhere from $25,000 down to $150, or a customized amount if you prefer. So again, grab your phone. You're going to click this link that we're just now sending you, right? Yep, we just sent you a link. Go ahead and click that so that you can play along. Now, yes, the first number that I'm going to ask for is $25,000. And I know that that might sound overwhelming, but don't let any of this overwhelm you. Because as Desmond Tutu said, you know, don't be overwhelmed by the greatness of things, right? Do your best where you can, how you can, and all those little good deeds together will overwhelm the world. And that's what we're here to do. So, $25,000 supports things like Canvas, which is an awesome online learning tool for the girls. It is top-notch. It's the best one out there. Some of the things that are great about this virtual learning experiences are the classrooms. They have these fun avatars of the teachers that the children can follow along with. It's user-friendly. It's easy on the parents to be able to integrate and learn. One of my favorite things, oh, by the way, I just see that we're up to already $20,000 right now. That's amazing. So thank you for all your bits and pieces. And again, I'm telling you about what these programs are supporting with all of your dollars that you're chipping in. So the fun part about Canvas as well, that's so important too, is that it works on phones, which is important because not all the children have computers or tablets to be able to do their work. So they can do their work, they can do college prep classes, they can read books, they can do all kinds of things on their phones. So I see that we're now up to $24,400, and I'm still wondering if we've got a $25,000 in the house. Do we? Is there anybody there in anybody's home? Is this something that you can, Emily Michaels, I see you coming in for $250. And who else is coming in? We've got Penelope Farms in for $250. Thank you so much. And we're already up to $52,000. Okay, I think I hear from somebody. There we are. Yes, I hear from somebody that we do have a $25,000 coming in, and it's coming in from the Gina H. Reed Family Foundation. Wow, thank you so much, Gina H. Reed Family Foundation. Thank you to Gina Reed. Thank you to the Gina H. Reed Family Foundation for your continued support. That's amazing. That $25,000 is going to help 5 girls continue and complete their college education. Gina Reed and to the Gina H. Reed Family Foundation from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for your continued support of Girls Inc. All right, let's go down to the $10,000 level and see what that supports. The $10,000 level supports supervision. Supervision is exactly kind of what it sounds like. It's supervision for the girls on their journeys right now. It's academic intervention program. Think of an academic intervention program that kind of starts at the beginning. So it might start with mental health checks and to see how the girls are, and it checks in on not only like what homework did you miss, but why did you miss the homework. In other words, what we do at Girls Inc. is not just pull a girl out of the river, but we're going upstream to figure out why they fell in. And it is your opportunity right now to reach out a hand to somebody and help pull them out of something and help their future head towards a brighter, brighter vision. We're up to $61,000 right now. I see Anna Marie Dunlap, I think my head's in the way, $500. Thank you so much for that. So again, we're at this $10,000 level. And what'd you say? And we've got a match? We've got a match. Okay, we've got a match. We've got a match coming in from? From Kaiser. Thank you so much to Kaiser for your match. So that's a $10,000 match. So is there anybody here who could give us another $10,000. That could unlock our $10,000 match. And I tell you what, you don't have to do it alone. You could text your girlfriends and say, hey, could you go in for $5,000 and I'll go in for $5,000, and that way we can together, we can make this happen. Text your friends, see if you want to do this together. Hadley Miller, thank you for your $250. I know that we'll get up to that $10,000. Let's see, it came in at about, we'll call it 60, I'm not sure, but when we get up to 70, we will have made that. So we're looking for a $10,000 if anybody can, to support supervision. This is a really great guidance tool for the kids, supervision, because truancy is a real issue right now. And the girls are falling through the cracks, and it can be your hand that reaches out and catches them from falling in the cracks. Alice Feneglio, I believe it went by super fast. Thank you for your donation. Hadley Miller, $250 as well. Thank you so, so much. Now let's go on to the $5,000 level and see what's down there. Oh, this is one of my favorites because this is for college essay writing. This is a very intensive lab for girls to learn how to write their college essays. They are working with mentors 2 to 3 times a week, college-educated mentors, some of them with master's degrees. It's a very intensive, as I said, 2 to 3 times per week program where the girls are writing essays for college to get in, of course. The important thing that you should know about this is during COVID, the SATs have been put on pause. And we can't normally go in and have an interview as we used to do back in, yes, we made the $71,000. Thank you. Yeah, round of applause to us. All right, we got that match. We're up to $71,000. Let's see what else we can bring in. So as I was saying about the college essay program, super important. Again, the SAT's been put on pause. So many kids these days, they don't go in for interviews like we used to back in the day. So the college essay is everything. And they have to have several different kinds, maybe 4 different kinds of essays, depending on the colleges that they're applying to. So this would be very, very helpful if you could donate $5,000 to the college essays. Oh, and I see that, if I'm not mistaken, we've got, this is very kind, Janet Michaels. Thank you. Janet and Mike Michaels are happy to use their $5,000 as a match. So we're at 72 right now, right? We're at 72. If we can get up to 77, then we will unlock that match. So y'all keep donating. And if you've donated once, you don't have to be done. You can donate again. Nothing's stopping you from donating again. Donating is like donuts. You don't have to have just one. What are we at?
Deborah Rodriguez with
$5,000. Deborah Rodriguez at $5,000. Thank you so much, Deborah. That's amazing. Thanks for pointing that out. Elizabeth Ekman at $50. Thank you so much. Every bit counts. We're up to $82,000. That's awesome. Let's go on to the next level. We're at $2,500. Now, if math was important to you, you'll like this level because it supports our logic lab. Our logic lab is an intensive project-based learning program. So, as I'm sure you probably know, project-based learning means that the children are starting to do things like plan a family vacation or learn how to invest in stocks and bonds. Real-world things. Why wait until you're an adult to figure these things out? I'm thrilled that they have these programs for kids. Rick Matros, thanks for your $1,000. What did we do?
$10,000
for Michelle Rose. That's amazing. Go, Michelle Rose. You guys are rock stars out there. Keep it pouring in. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, so again, so I don't know if it was the math that said it, but thank you so much, Michelle. Let's keep talking about that math then. This program, this is so fun. The Logic Lab, they create fun games for the girls to play, like Mathopoly, where if you do the math equation and you answer it correctly, you get money, which is a lot like real world, if you ask me. So, oh, this is awesome. We're up to $91,000. What did you say? Can you talk louder? Michelle what?
From Hoke.
Michelle from Hoke.
Michelle with Hoke.
Hoke Hospital.
Oh, from Hoke Hospital. Okay, yeah, right. Speak up or I'm going to drag you over here and you're going to be a part of this with me. All right, let's go on to $1,000. Don't be shy. You guys don't be shy and you guys don't be shy. Let's go on for $1,000. What you got?
Barbara Bowman.
How much?
$2,500
from Barbara Bowman. That's amazing. Thank you so much, Barbara Bowman. You rock. Thank you so much. Now let's move on to the $1,000. Oh, we're at $97,000 right now. Let's get it over $100,000 for sure. We're going to shoot for the stars on this one. So $1,000 supports application fees. This is super important as well because, as you heard, girls come from families with limited means, and they might not be able to afford more than one college education, or excuse me, one college application. So the girls might have to err on the side of picking their safety school, and they might be afraid of their REACH school. What? Jan Slater in for $1,500. Thank you so much. Ooh, we're up to $99,500. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Let's get it up easily over 100, maybe 125. Could we do it? That'd be amazing. But I'm hoping for 100 right now. So we're at that $1,000 level, which supports application fees. The application fees, as you remember when you went to college, they're about $75 or $100. This is a lot of money for the parents to come up with. And if the children have to do work and have jobs to create their own application fees, then they're not studying and they're not here at Girls Inc., which is where we want them. So please help us out. Help us get to $100,000 and donate $1,000 right now. This is an opportunity for the children to go to a great school. You know how important that is. And I've heard that we're only as great as the opportunities given to us. I don't know if that's necessarily true, but I know that this is an incredible opportunity for you to write the story of your life tonight, or this afternoon. You could write yourself in as a hero. Come on in and donate that. Yes, $1,000. So we've got $100,150. All right, let's keep it going. Let's see those names keep popping up on the board. We're at $500 now, which supports the Literacy Lab. Literacy Girls Inc. Champion is coming in at $10,000. Oh, that's amazing. So we've got an anonymous donor at $10,000. Thank you so much. And anybody, I meant to mention this, anybody who donates $1,000 or more joins our Giving Society of Girls Inc. It's the Champions Giving Society. So if you'd like to be a part of that Giving Society, please donate $1,000 or more. We promise we won't ask you to have to come to many meetings. It's just part of a feel-good, do-good situation. Chef Jamie, $500. Thank you so much for that. We're up to $111,000. What do you got?
Chef Jamie and Jagger.
And Jagger. Thank you, Chef Jamie and Jagger. I couldn't read it fast enough. Thank you so much. Let's see, where else are we? We're at $500. This is going to be for the Literacy Lab. Let's keep them pouring in, even if you create a number that you like. If you were born in 1971, or your best friend was, donate $1,971. We're up to $111,000. Let's see if we can get up to $125,000. Is it possible? Let's donate $500 to get the girls some books. Let's have somebody else come in. Go grab your phone and donate again. What
Steve
do we got?
Elin.
Steve Elin came in.
Kate Elin.
Kate Elin came in. Thank you so much for your $1,500. That's massive. Thank you so much. All right. Oh, and Mary Dutch for $100. Thank you so much. Now we're going to go down to our $250 level, which is for mentoring. And the reason why mentoring is so important is because it's not just any volunteer that mentors, though we have great volunteers, college-educated, master's degrees volunteers. We're up to 130. Oh, we've got Francis. Dierks, $1,500. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your $1,500. We so appreciate you. We're up to 114 right now. Let's see if we can get up to at least 125. What do you got?
I've got another gift of $2,500 from Scott Sherman.
$2,500 from Scott Sherman. Thank you so much, Scott Sherman. You're a rock star. Thank you so much. That's amazing. We're up to 114 right now. Let's see what else we can get it up to. We're at the $250 level right now. And this is, again, this supports the mentors who are helping our kids and holding on to their hands. I tell you, and right now is a really tough time for kids at home. I know that Lucy told you earlier that, you know, sadly, abuse is on the rise, and the girls need a safe place to come to, like Girls Inc., and to their mentor to be able to say, hey, I'm not safe at home at my kitchen table. So your money is really changing people's lives. So thank you so much for everybody who's donated. We're at $114,000 right now. We've got one more level. Let's try to get it up to $125,000 if it's possible. Let's see if we can do, oh, Jeff came in for, I couldn't see that, Jeff Van Hofstar, kids. Girls, gotcha. Okay, we're at $150 for the college shower. This is what the college shower supports. This is fun. So when they do go to college, they need to have the support when they go to college of organization and what comes next. What comes next when we go to college? We have a marriage. We have a marriage shower. We know it comes next. We have a baby. We have a baby shower. So we get support and we know it comes next. But going to college is your own rite of passage for you. And so you're going to get a college shower. What we do is we give the girls baskets full of everything that they might need, backpacks, extension cords, you name it. It's there to support them so that when they get there, they've got everything that they need to make themselves into the honor student that they want to be. We're at $114,500 right now. Love to get it up to over $125,000 before the event ends. And the good news is we're going to leave this giving open for a week. So please feel free to copy our link and send it to your friends, send it to your family. If they could donate $25, anything they could to help make the world a better place for these girls would be amazing. My name is Zan. This is the end of this fundraising portion of the evening, but it's not the end of the fundraising. Again, we're going to keep it open for a week. Thank you so much to all of our donors. And now I want to hand it back over to Bea and Lucy.
Wow, I can't believe, wow, I can't believe it. This is so much fun. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to host.
Bea, you've been amazing today. You make sure that you check out that chat box. I think I saw a comment saying Bea for president. So you just never know what's going to happen. So we are so appreciative of everybody. I was nearly in tears as I was looking at the chat box and all the comments, really being able to see what our Girls Inc. Girl alumnas are saying on the chat box. But I get the best part of the job today, and that is to share with you the kind of investment that you've made in Girls Inc. today. And so today we have raised a total of $117,000 through our sponsor of girls. So thank you so much. And for a grand total so far of $460,000. That means that you are helping us to make investments in Bea, in Sanaya, all of the girls in the chat box, our alumna. Oh my gosh, I'm going to get emotional. So thank you so much today for all of your support. We are truly, truly blessed. And I do want to say that that total also includes $20,000 that was raised through the private jet sale. We ended up doing it as a private side, but we are so grateful to our sponsors that one, donated the jet, but also to those that chose to invest in Girls Inc. through that. So thank you so, so much. We are so thrilled. So today we are grateful to all of you for being our sponsors, being our donors, being our friends, being our volunteers in the organization, and helping us to mentor and really inspire more girls to be strong, smart, and bold. We're not done yet. I have a couple more things. One of the things I wanted to mention is you may have noticed on your screen an orange line that's right below our screen. Well, that is part of our new branding. We have some really great new stuff that we're going to be rolling out, and we're really excited to showcase it with all of you here today. So stay tuned for more. We're super excited about that. And that is just one of the many things to come that Girls Inc. is waiting for. So the last thing I want to say is I'm going to give it back to Bella. But yeah.
Now I've got a fun announcement, and that's the winners of our online auction. For those who have won in our auction, you'll be receiving a text message right now confirming your win. Congratulations to all of our highest bidders.
And we hope that you've all enjoyed the delicious lunch for those of you that received it, or whatever that you were enjoying today. We hope that you got to learn a little bit more about what Girls Inc. is doing here in Orange County. And we hope that you will continue to stay connected to us. We hope that you will share the YouTube video once you get the link after the event and share it with more friends. The more friends, the merrier. We want to bring in everybody that can learn about Girls Inc. to help us inspire more girls. So thank you today to all of you. We are so thrilled. We are, today is just one of those days where we really get to celebrate the work that we do each and every day. You've inspired so many girls today, and we thank you so, so much. And Bea, you did an amazing job being our host, and you're just amazing. So thank you so much.
Thank
we appreciate
you.
Your time and energy and commitment to Girls Inc. and stay strong, smart, and bold. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you.